Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in El Segundo, California. When I heard this, where LAX is, that reminds me of Fred Sanford. That was, he used to talk about going to El Segundo. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm here. You can hear, I don't know if you can hear it, there's airplanes taking off. And anyway, so we're here near LAX and we'll be flying out tomorrow back to the Philippines. As you guys know, my father-in-law passed away suddenly yesterday of heart trouble. He was a Christian. He was a Christian for about the last 15, 20 years. And anyway, he was helping me oversee the, he was overseeing the ministry while I was gone, checking up on everybody. So he's lost to, of course, Joshua's ministry besides his family, to the church, to the body of Christ. So we ask for your prayers for that. Brothers and sisters, thank you for all of your prayers and condolences that you messaged me. I really appreciate it. I'm going to continue with the words for people. When I get back to the Philippines, I've got about 25 or 30 names. And on the bottoms of the videos now, as I'd asked after the first one, that people would comment from the word I gave and say, you know, whether it was right or not. And so I thank the Lord for that as a confirmation. And I was just thinking about that this afternoon, that you don't see anybody doing that. I mean, the people that you go to some church, a lot of times they're given some word and it's like, you know, God's going to make you a millionaire and all this kind of stuff or whatever. And then you don't see, there's been very few preachers that, you know, could just have somebody's, by the gift of the word of knowledge and word of wisdom and things like that, and just start, just have a list of names and start giving people words as the Lord would give it to them. And the whole point of this for me personally, brothers and sisters, is the Lord would use it to open up doors so I could go do revivals at churches. And plus, of course, some, you know, faith of people would be built up by this. The individuals who receive a word, their faith would be built up, and the Lord would exhort them and encourage them to run their race for Him and get them on the right track. And then also even to bring revival to churches, to bring atheists to the belief of in the Lord because of you know, they heard it and it was true. Things like that. So it's a huge thing, and that's why God gives us the gifts of the Spirit. As Brother Carmen says, the gifts of the Spirit are like atomic bombs. You know, they bring a big-time damage to the kingdom of Satan. That's the purpose of these power gifts of the Spirit, to bring, you know, the power of God down on the enemy. So brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray for that, that the Lord would use these videos. As the Lord had told me at the beginning of January, the Lord told me to go public with more openly public, and the Bible says, you know, prophesy according to your faith. What is that, Romans chapter? I can't remember now. It's off the top of my head. Maybe Romans chapter 12. But anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord had changed me from doing it to individuals in private and then through messages and in person in private, to doing it this public thing that I started with these words of wisdom and words of knowledge for people and a prophecy for people, really, at the beginning of this January 2014. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm asking you to pray about that also, that the Lord would use this to open the doors, to get into churches and even Christian television, radio, and all those kind of things, to bring the gifts of the Spirit to the body of Christ, and all those things, to bring revival, to win those lost to the Lord, to bring back sliders back, the lukewarm, to be on fire for the Lord, to bring revival. All of the things are produced by many things that God can do, and one of them is through the gifts of the Spirit, like healing ministries and things like that. So, brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray for that. I know that's what the Lord has got lined up for me to do, and if you've been following my videos, I haven't, you know, said it this way, as the Lord has given more clarity on it, because God causes all things to work together for the good of those who love Him, who are called according to His purposes. So that's Romans 8:28. So as an example, you know, as the Lord would open the door for me to go to more churches, give people words of wisdom, you know, I didn't just see the things the way the Lord shows me. I go there, I give people words. People who are non-believers, they hear about it from their relatives, whatever, they come, they get saved. Those who are lukewarm and hiding in the church, they get on fire because, hey, God's really real. God's really alive. God's really active. Bring repentance and revival to that church. Then secondary to that, some people in the church will say, hey, I want to sponsor an orphan. Hey, I want to build a new orphanage. See, and then other churches will invite me. I'll be able to travel there and meet with people. local people outside the church too. Pray for people, minister to people, go here or there. And at the same time, there'll be more people who will help sponsor the orphanage, the feeding programs and all that also. So all things work together for the good of those who love God. So I ask you to pray about that, that this vision that the Lord has been, you know, increasing my understanding about what's his purpose and plan for me and Joshua's ministry and the church of the firstborn. I always have the links below the video. The church that the Lord told me to start too in the beginning of January this year, online virtual church. And our prayer requests, we're receiving them, and we have their prayer warriors lined up. And I keep forgetting to mention about this. If you have a prayer request, go to the website, churchfirstborn.com. It's under this video. You can submit your prayer request. There's a section with different, we've already got several categories. We're going to add more categories. Categories you can go in there, like you want to talk to somebody, or you're trying to get off of drinking, drugs, whatever. Brother Sid is the one for that. New Christians, evangelism and brand new Christians. It's Brother Darren in Dallas, healing. Brother Brian, OT4Jesus in Houston. And there's several others. I didn't name them all. Anyway, brothers and sisters, that's what's going on with us right now. Getting ready to head back to the Philippines. I'll be doing the funeral myself. In the Philippines, they usually have 9 days wake. So we'll be doing that. And so I guess the funeral is going to be next Saturday or Sunday or something like that. I don't know yet. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I keep you posted on that. And I hope that the Lord will use the funeral. Most of my wife's relatives are not Christian. It's only her immediate family. So I pray that the Lord will use this, because lots of her dad's relatives will be coming. Almost 100% of them are not born-again Christians, so I'll be doing the funeral. But every night at the wake, we will have preaching. We have local preachers who will come in, Filipino preachers, and do the preaching. And then I will do the actual funeral. And pray, brothers and sisters, that, you know, there'll be dozens and dozens, maybe even 100 people who will hear the preaching, and that some of them will get saved, the relatives of my father-in-law. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. I was going to mention something else. Yes, Sister Pearlie. I keep forgetting to mention. Someone just asked me about that, and I've got a message. I sent him the info. I'll have the info below this video, too, for sending stuff to the Philippines. If you have, there's no need to send any clothes if they're gone, you know, if they're bad. But if they're, you know, just slightly, you know, gently used, children particularly, but summer clothes. We don't need any kind of coats and stuff in the Philippines. It's always hot. Children's clothes, particularly summer clothes, even adult summer clothes, where there's lots of poor people, we can give them to the parents of some of the kids at the feedings and things like that. Some of the pastors. Lots of pastors don't have any hardy clothes. Their wives, their families, can give it to them. Flip-flops, of course, we can buy them here for about 70 cents a pair. So it's hard to buy them that cheap in the States and send them here. It's probably better for us to buy the flip-flops here. If people, you know, if you want to get involved in that too. So I was talking to a sister about that today from North Carolina, about buying the flip-flops here. It's much cheaper. But anything like that, school supplies, I've made videos about this in the past. School supplies, pencils, papers, crayons, that's a biggie, coloring books, all that kind of stuff, brothers and sisters. Anything for children that don't have anything. You know, every time I stay at a hotel, there's always crazy people around me. I know it's the enemy. There's some people next door that got their window open, and I think they're drunk. They've been carrying on foolishness. It's already, whatever, 11:30 at night here. Anyway, God bless you guys. I appreciate all of your prayers, all of your love, and I appreciate a few people have donated to help me out, because we have to buy new tickets in the Philippines from Manila down to the island we're on, and whatever else is other expenses that got involved in that. But thank the Lord, too, Delta, of course. They have a policy, if someone died, immediate family, they will change your ticket flight date for free. So I thank the Lord for that. And then, you know, so it reduced our expenses a lot in that part. Had to rent a car, though, to come down here to L.A. from Bakersfield one way. But I thank the Lord. Some people have donated. I appreciate that, all of you guys. I forgot what I was going to mention. There's a sister from, I don't want to say her name. A sister from Ohio. I don't know her YouTube name versus her. She sent me a nice card and an offering, and I don't have her. Her name is not. I don't have her real name connected with her YouTube name. I want to thank her. she's from Ohio, I think it is. Forgive me if I'm wrong, because, you know, I'm lack of sleep, but I think it's Ohio. Anyway, yes, sister, I want to thank you. God bless you. And I was in a hurry to get down here, and I don't have the card in my hand. I just want to thank you for that, sister, for that offering for the orphans. So God bless. God bless you guys. You'll see me, by the grace of God, making videos there from Mindanao Island, Philippines, after a couple more days. God bless.